Hey guys, welcome back. Assume this, you load a CSV file into your data warehouse, maybe from S3, maybe from a batch pipe. You run a copy into or load data command and it completes. But have you ever wondered what actually happens under the hood? How is your data stored? In rows, in column, in files, or in blocks? Is it compressed, partitioned, indexed? Well, in this video, we are going to deep dive into what really happens when data enters in a modern data warehouse. Let's assume we are loading a CSV file into a data warehouse. Let's take a closer look at the data. This is file had 16 records, 6 customers, 3 different months, January, February, and March. The first thing the data warehouse does, it distributes the data into logical partition based on the partition key. So it places January data into January partition, February data into the February partition, and March data into the March partition. This is crucial for a query efficiency. The system can skip entire partition during query execution through partition pruning. If a query only needs January data, it skips scanning other partition and reads only the January group. Now let's zoom even further in the data warehouse. Assuming we have 3 nodes data warehouse, so this data will not directly go and sit in single big machine. It will get distributed in the all nodes, and this distribution will happen based on the distribution key that we are given while creating the table. The data warehouse automatically distributes the partition row across physical nodes using a distribution key, in this case customer ID. Customer ID is the distribution key, so based on the customer ID, data will get distributed across the nodes. A hash function is applied to each customer ID, which returns a node number. The data is then sent to the respective node based on the result. Hash function is designed in a way that for a particular value of partition key, it will always return the same number. So all the data with same customer ID will always go in the same node. Assume hash function 101 always returns 1. So all data with customer ID 101 will go in node 1. And internally in node 1, it will be distributed in a manner that January data go in partition 0, February data goes in partition 2, and March data will go in partition 3. And assume hash function 102 always return 2, so all the data will go in node 2 in the same manner. And assume hash function 103 always return 3, so all the data will go in node 3 in same manner. This ensures data locality, parallel processing, spatially efficient joins, scans, and aggregations. Well, choosing the right distribution key is important. It helps balance the data and prevent node overload. Understand it like this. You have a region in your data and your e-commerce application operates in 5 regions. That is India, US, UK, France, and Canada. And your 80% of sale is coming from India, and you have chosen region as your distribution key, then 80% of your data will be skewed in one node. That will not be good for your data house performance, because one node is doing 80% of work and other two nodes just doing 20% of work. So distribution of the data properly in all nodes is very important when you work with any distributed system like data warehouse. All right, you are probably thinking, okay, I get it. I have learned how data is distributed across nodes in a data warehouse. And yes, you are thinking in the right direction. But the story doesn't end at the nodes. Each node is further broken down into smaller units to push parallel processing to even higher level. And this is where the real power of the data warehouse kicks in. Let's take a closer look at how this magic unfolds. Each node contains multiple slices, lightweight compute unit with their own CPU and memory. Think of them as mini workers inside a node, each capable of processing its own chunks of data independently. Now, how many slices each node has? Well, that's depend entirely on your cluster configuration and the instant type you chose as a node. When a node receives data, it doesn't store everything in one place. Instead, it distributes the data across its slices, not based on any distribution key like we saw in the node label. Slicing is handled entirely by the system, either randomly or using a round robin strategy, but always with one goal, distribution. For example, if node 0 has 100 records in partition 0 and it has 4 slices, the system ensures that each slice gets 25 records perfectly balanced. Now let's take node 1 handling partition 1. It received 4 records for January user ID 101. The system will distribute this evenly, one record per slice, making sure no single slice is overloaded. Now let's say for February and March, user 101 only has one record each. Since there is just single record, the system will place it into any one of the slices. The choice is left to the system's internal logic, which could be random or round robin. And this same process continues for node 2, node 3 and beyond. Each node distributes its incoming data across its own slices, always aiming for the balanced parallel execution. This even slicing across nodes and partitions is what enables massive parallel query execution, making data warehouses incredibly fast and scalable. So now, with 3 nodes and 4 slices per node, you have got a total 12 slices working in parallel. That means up to 12 parallel processing units during both data ingestion and query execution. This is the secret sauce behind the speed and scalability of modern data warehouse. More slices, more power, and massively parallel processing at every stage. Now here is the game changer. Unlike traditional database that stored data row by row, modern data warehouse take completely different approach. They store data column by column. Let's break that down. Imagine we have a simple table with a few rows and data. In a traditional database, this data would be stored row by row, each row placed into a separate data block, one after the another. But in a modern data warehouse, that same data gets stored column by column. That means all values from the first column are stored together. Then all values from the second column and so on. Each column is written into its own columnar block. This architectural shift gives us a massive edge when it comes to analytics. Say we run a query that only needs the ID and region columns. The system doesn't waste time scanning the entire table. It skips the unnecessary columns entirely and only reads what's needed. This smart optimization is called column pruning. And the result? Reduced I/O, faster query performance, and more efficient analytics. Next comes the compression. And this is where the columnar format truly shines. because each column stores similar or repetitive values. It opens the door for powerful compression techniques. Let's say you have a product category column within these values. Now, instead of storing the full string every time, the system builds a dictionary like this and replaces the original column with just the codes. So instead of repeatedly storing long text like electronics or furniture, you are storing tiny integers, much more efficient. This compression is called dictionary encoding. Let's look into another example. Suppose you have a status column like this. Instead of storing all six values, RLE encoder encodes it like this. That's it. Just two entries instead of six. This encoding is called run length encoding. And the result is up to 10x smaller storage footprint and significantly faster scans during query execution. All of this happens automatically behind the scene, handled entirely by the data warehouse engine. Finally, the data warehouse store metadata about where each block lives, what partitions exist, which column ranges are stored where. This metadata enables partition pruning, column pruning, predicate pushdown, massive parallelism, all under the hood. That's the power of a modern distributed data warehouse. It's not just about storing data. It's about smart storage, efficient compute, and ultra-fast queries, all working together invisibly. This is how Amazon, Walmart, Netflix, and others make data-driven decisions in seconds, not weeks. So let's recap. When you store data in data warehouse, it's stored in column, not rows. It's partitioned, clustered, and compressed. It's accompanied by the metadata that allows fast filtering, and it becomes query ready at scale. You don't have to manage indexes or tune block sizes manually. The data warehouse does it all for you behind the scenes. If you found this breakdown helpful, wait until you see what happens during query execution. Check out the next video in this series. What happens when you run a SQL query in a data warehouse? Subscribe and stay tuned.